Hey, you! Clown. Buzz off.
You, Giacomo. They're waiting for you upstairs. Don't worry. Don't keep them waiting.
Tell me, what do you think about all this?
Giacomo, God be praised. I knew you could do it, but I was still worried.
Did you bring the Chronicle?
We were successful after all.
Just as I hoped. The Chronicle records the whole history of this secret order, this Ordo Eustatalis. I will need a moment to find what we are looking for, but this is immensely interesting. I should probably introduce you. Next to me stands my great friend and advisor. I owe much to him and consider him the most erudite friar in the whole clergy. Honorable Luca Bartolomeo Pacioli.
Don't exaggerate, Leonardo. You underrate my brothers.
That is not my intention, but it is still my opinion. And before us is my disciple and assistant, about whom I have spoken so much. A man possibly brought to me by fate itself to help me carry the weight of my burden. Messer Giacomo Andrea de Ferrara.
I greet you, Giacomo. Please, don't blame Leonardo for his bluntness. He couldn't wait to read the Chronicle. I'm sure you've noticed that when he gets like this, there is no talking to him. Sit down, have a bite. You must be tired after your journey. We have a veritable feast here. Vegetables, pastries, fruit. More vegetables. Well, your master isn't the funnest person in the world, but you surely noticed that as well.
Luca makes fun of me often, but this time I'm really not able to find out where the point is hiding. He would do better to focus on real problems.
See? Just like I said. But seriously, real problems. I'm sure Leonardo told you how, once upon a time, he met Cesar Borgia with members of a secret society. They brought fragmented plans for some strange machine and asked him to construct it for them. At first, he agreed, but when he found out what a terrible weapon the machine could become, he decided not to give it to them.
I see. There can be no more doubt. The secret society was indeed Ordo Eustatalis. They also had plans for the time machine, however incomplete, because in the past they had a similar time machine, so why did they need my help?
Either way, in the end, Ordo Eustatalis took the machine from the tower of Badia Fiorentina, shortly after Leonardo used it, and just moments after you did as well, Giacomo, when you tried to save your very life from the half-crazed Borgia who took your glove before you came to? I wonder what the story was with the Duke. When they came with the plans, he seemed to have a position of power within the Order, but after your escape to Florence, they didn't cooperate at all. And that's something we should thank Providence for, because until Ordo Eustatalis obtains one of the gloves, they can't use the machine, even if they are able to reconstruct it.
Aha! Here, right at the end of the Chronicle. But the year 1465 after Christ came. And for the Order of the Justice, the world was never the same. During that event, their time machine, which they'd called the Gate of the Temple of Wisdom, must have been damaged. That is why they needed my help.
So, to summarize, the Order took Leonardo's time machine, and we don't know where. Borgia took Giacomo's glove, and we don't know where. At least, we still have the one Leonardo came with, which is broken. Seriously, gentlemen, and I say this as your friend, you should start looking after your things.
That would be an excellent analysis, Luco, if not for the sarcasm and one small mistake that I will correct in a moment. But before that, could you give me the glove?
Here it is. Pretty, but broken.
Fortunately, that does not matter at all. There is one thing I haven't told you yet, my friends. When Borgia came to me all those years ago, he had not only those incomplete plans to build a time machine, but also three ampules with a strange liquid. I don't know where they came from, but they react to open the gate of time. Thanks to them, I can determine where the gate should take us. An ampule is set in each glove, and one in the Oculus Perpetua. Each of them, when set correctly, will allow us to jump through the gate a maximum 15 years in time. This means that if we wanted to travel back to the original time machine in the year 1465, 45 years in the past, we would need all three of them.
So you insist that we need to destroy the original time machine? Completely wipe it from history? No matter the risk, no matter how hard it might be?
As long as the Order has the plans and the will to use it, mankind will never be safe from the invention. I regretted having started working on the time machine. But what do you think would have happened if I had sent them away?
I suppose they would try to find someone else? But I'm sure that nobody else would be able to finish it with such incomplete plans.
Perhaps. Perhaps not. But if not now, then what about in a year, 10 years, 1,000 years? Sooner or later, someone would do it. All it would take would be one moment of weakness and a great deal of naivety or bad intentions, and the world as we know it could cease to exist. No, my friend, trust me that there is no other way. The machine should never have been in human hands.
You are right, Leonardo. I know you have thought about it for a long time, and I trust that your decision is not made lightly. I think I can speak for the both of us when I say that we stand behind you. Well, I think it is high time that we told Giacomo the whole truth about why we met here.
All right. It is true that we don't know where the time machine is, but we know how to get the third ampule because Borgia will surely keep the glove close. And we do know where he is hiding. Just across the street, in the tall building.
Ja couldn't have found a better hiding spot. No normal person would step foot in this neighborhood. Marco was rather surprised when he saw him here. Marco is the jolly man who welcomed you downstairs. He has a lot of friends around, and they learned that Borgia's hideout is very well prepared for, uninvited guests. but right next to it is a burnt pub. Perhaps it would be possible to get inside through that.
Just before you arrived, Marco informed us that Borgia left. We have a unique opportunity to get in and take the glove. Giacomo, out of all of us, you are best suited for this task. We leave it in your hands. Be careful.